Welcome to JCE Connect Module 3, Part 6, Subject Human Resource Management, Subject Code 18 MBA 21. Let us move on to recruitment sources in India. So we have various sources which are being followed in India. Of them, most popular are internal sources, public employment exchange, vacancies, labor contractors, casual laborers, private employment agencies, consultants, campus recruitment, data banks, e-recruitment, social media recruitment. So these are various sources of recruitment which are being followed in India. Explanation of these sources are given in the previous videos. Let us move on to recruitment practices in India. First, we have outsourcing. This method is usually undertaken by companies as a cost-cutting measure and usually involves hiring a party outside a company to perform services that were previously performed by the company's own staff. So by making an appropriate pool of ability, the outsourcing firms help the association for screening the candidates for necessities of the organization. Next, you have e-recruitment. Internet is a main source of recruitment for many big organizations. The companies advertise their vacancies through their World Wide Web. The candidates in turn apply for these vacancies through the company web page. The major advantage of this technique is that it doesn't incur high cost and no intermediaries are required. And also there is reduction in time of recruitment. Then next we have screening. So due to artificial intelligence being coming in, the process of screening bulk amount of candidates' resume has become very easy. So to ensure no unsuitable candidates are screened, the job descriptions are matched with the resume and by using artificial intelligence, and you pick the right candidate for the next process. So this is quicker and more efficient to screen a candidate. Then you have increased demand for employee referrals. This is one of the most predictable trends of recruitment which is going on in India. Every organization relies upon employee referrals and in turn the employee is paid bonus on referrals. Then you have employer brand, which is again the trend which is picking up in India. As opposed to corporate brand reputation and value proposition, employer brand has gained much of popularity. So it is the view of all the companies in India wherein they will be producing or having a video of their own employees speaking about the company, the working environment of the company, the way the positive response of the company, and taking all this into consideration, they post the videos to the relevant public, and ultimately you are creating the brand in the mind of the public by creating a positive image about the company. Then you have candidate experience. It is nothing but current, past, as well as potential future candidates who are there. Overall perception of your company's recruiting process. So it is based on feeling of the candidate, behavior of the candidate, and attitude which they experienced during the whole recruitment process from sourcing and screening to the interview. So hiring and finally onboarding. So the candidate has to have a very happy experience when it comes to recruitment process. That is a trend or practice which is followed in India. Then you have social recruiting, which is very much influenced. So here if you could see many of the students, the public will be more on Facebook, Twitter, LinkedIn. The officials will be more on LinkedIn. It is the professional networking side. And also they go in for social recruitment through websites like Glassdoor, Blog, Forum, Job Boards. So more than posting current job vacancies on the company's social media network account, it goes beyond the social recruiting. So through social recruiting, the company can use social media networks in proactively searching the potential candidate and building a strong relationship with them. Then the final one you have, data-driven recruiting, which is the practice which is followed in India, is also one of the aspects used to demonstrate recruiting methods through which HR planning and decision making are based on entirely data acquired through HR technology. So they acquire the data through HR technology such as applicant tracking system, recruitment marketing platforms. They get the data, and based on the data, they go in for the decisions of recruitment. Then you have the next one, which is recruiting trends according to Monster 2019. So according to Monster, it says artificial intelligence focus will shift to the front end of the recruitment process. So employers will be using the artificial intelligence, that is a technology, to filter and pre-screen candidates and reduce recruiters' workload. So technologies like chatbots will improve the response time to the candidates' inquiry. Then video will become even more important to recruitment. So we have recruitment marketing, wherein they will be using the video of the employees, wherein the employees will be speaking about the positive points of the company as well as their stay, the happy experience what they have during their stay in the organization, which improves the employee value proposition and can make a huge difference in how effectively your organization attracts and maintains interest from the qualified candidates. Then more innovative ways to leverage video, which includes video job description, video job description through Monster Studio app, which is launched in 2019. You will also be able to record, edit and post videos with your job ads and using the app as on a smartphone. Then you have recruitment technology will become increasingly focused on integration. So hiring the potential candidates becomes the new mantra. So companies will be looking in for potential candidates, the candidates who are competent enough to give the best to the organization, and better analysis of recruitment data will drive better outcomes. So these are the different recruitment trends according to Monster in 2019. Now coming down to the next part of module 3, that is selection. So what is selection? It is nothing but choosing from a pool of applicants the person or persons who offer the greatest performance potential. Selection is done through certain selection test. Now what is this selection test? It is nothing but work sample test or performance specific test, or the task, specific tasks which are performed in the job, you take a test, work sample test on them. These type of tests aim to replicate actual job or situation to assess if the candidate has the skill, experience and qualification required to carry out the work. Coming on to procedure of selection. First procedure is screening the application, preliminary interview, application blank, checking of references and background check, psychological test, group discussion, employment interview, approval and physical examination. The procedure keeps on changing from job to job as well as from organization to organization or based on the situation. Let us move on to the first part of selection process, that is screening of applications. So based on job analysis, that is job description and job specification, applicants are shortlisted for their interview. So application consists of demographics and lifestyle questions that are found to be sound predictors of job performance. Then you have preliminary interview. It may be a telephonic interview, online interview, etc. It involves giving prospective candidate the information about the job and the organization. At the same time, collect information about prospective candidate's education, skill, expected salary, etc. Then you have application blank. So here candidates are asked to fill the company application form, which provides the information on range of topics such as last salary drawn, qualification, reason for wanting to apply for the job, reason for leaving the last organization, etc. Then you have background investigation and reference check. Here you verify the information being provided in the application form. The type of information which are being verified, it includes former employers, previous job performances, education, legal status to work, credit references, criminal records, all these are being verified. When it comes to background investigation, it does not always provide an organization with meaningful information about the applicants. So it doesn't mean that all the time background investigation will give the right information about the candidate. So concerns over legality of asking for and providing confidential information about the applicant. Certain times it becomes very difficult to get the information about the applicant, because certain information may be confidential, like credit information or maybe previous employer performance information and all those things. So top employee background providers include Kroll background screening group, Choice Point, First Advantage. So many of the companies, they go in for outsourcing this work to certain employee background providers, wherein they provide the entire information about the candidate. Then you have the selection test or the psychological test, which is used to further screen the applicants by gathering additional job relevant information. So common type of employment tests are intelligence test, aptitude test, personality test and job knowledge. Let's first see what is this aptitude test. It is nothing but it measures the candidate's potential to learn skills, clerical, mechanical, mathematical, logical, etc. So these tests indicate the individual's ability to learn a given job quickly and efficiently. Aptitude test does not measure the job motivation, because of which aptitude is administered in combination with other tests like intelligence and personality test. Then you have intelligence test, which judges the mental ability of the candidate. It measures the ability to understand the instructions, make judgment and learning ability. So here several traits are being measured of an individual, such as memory, vocabulary, verbal fluency, numerical ability, perception, spatial visualization, etc. Then you have personality test, which is basically used to measure the basic aspects of an applicant personality, such as motivation, emotional balance, emotional intelligence, self-confidence, interpersonal behavior, introvert, extrovert, etc. You have job knowledge test, which measures the knowledge related to the job. So here some of the examples are computer language for IT firms, technological knowledge for engineering industries, financial knowledge for the banks. Then you have employment test. Basically, when you speak about employment test, so estimates say 60% of all the organizations use some type of employment test. So it may be performance simulation test, which requires the applicant to engage in specific job behavior necessary for doing the job successfully. It also involves work sampling test, which is being used to develop a miniature replica of the job on which the applicant demonstrates his or her skills. Again, we have assessment center, wherein a series of tests and exercise including individual and group simulation test is used to assess managerial potential or other complex sets of skills. Then testing in global arena, basically into multinational industries, selection practices must be adapted based on the culture and regulation of the post country where you want to post the candidate. Then you have group discussion, which is the next process of selection. So here you measure the candidate's social, interactive and influencing skills. So topic or business problem is being given in the GD, which assesses certain job related attributes of the candidate. So here a group is being formed and you give a topic to that particular group and you see the interactiveness of each and every candidate, the social relationship. Then afterwards, the way the candidate communicates, the initiation, leadership skills, the influencing skills, all these are being judged in the group interview. So next comes the employment interview. It is nothing but face-to-face interaction, face-to-face meeting of the candidate with the employer or with the interviewer. So here, there are two strategies for effective use of interview. One is structuring the interview to be reliable and varied. It is being called a structured interview, and also training managers on the best interview skills. You train the managers on how to take an interview. These are the two strategies which are being used for effective use of interview. Then you have types of interview. Unstructured interview. Here each interviewer forms an independent opinion after asking different questions. And then you have structured interview. An interview in which the applicant is interviewed sequentially by several persons. Each read the applicant in the standard format or standard form. So unstructured interview is nothing but unplanned or which is not very much structured. Step-by-step application is not there. So it is entirely unstructured. So every interviewer will be having an independent opinion about the candidate. Lastly, the opinions are being clubbed and then final decision is being taken. But in structured interview, it is a planned interview. Step by step planning is being done, and each person rates on certain attributes, and totally it is being combined at the end. So it is into a standard format. Then you have types of interview, that is panel interview, which is being, it is an interview which is being taken by a group of interviewers, question the applicant, and then combine the ratings into a final score. So imagine having two or three or even more people interviewing you all at once. That's what panel interview is all about. It gives employer multiple opinions about you. So your job is to engage each member of the panel when answering the question. Start by making eye contacts with the person who has posed the query. Then gradually shift your focus to each of the other panel members while continuing to answer the questions. Then you have mass interview, which is nothing but a panel interview, interviews several candidates simultaneously. So here there will be a panel which will be interviewing several candidates at once or simultaneously. That is nothing but called as mass interview. Then you have something called as stress interview. So here you have been given an in-basket full of tasks. The interviewer gives you 20 minutes to sort out through the task and put them in proper priority or part away through the session. Your interviewer suddenly starts asking two or three questions at a time, glaring at you when you are trying to answer, then suddenly gets up and walks out of the out for a few minutes, no explanation supplied. Chances are you are being stressed, you are being into a stress interview. The employer puts you under pressure to see how you react. You show them what you have made by keeping your cool mind. So the more they continue to apply the tension, the calmer you become. That is nothing but called as stress interview. Too many tasks are being given at once and you have to sort it out and do it. Then you have job related interview, something the interview which is the questions will be asked related to the job which you have applied for. They do understand your experience as well as your competence towards getting that job done. Then you have case interview, which is nothing but the employer gives you a problem or topic for which you must prepare a presentation either before arriving or directly on the spot. They want to see how you communicate your ideas in front of a small group as well as how well you bring up the innovativeness into your ideas in solving the problem. Then you have lunch or dinner or mealtime interview, which is called as. So here the interviews is conducted at lunch and dinner tables. So this type of interview is conducted when candidate is being judged for interpersonal skills and social behavior. So here you have to make sure that you order wisely and make sure that you do not spill your drink, as well as you communicate properly and you have good table manners. Then somewhere you also bring in behavioral interview, where an interviewer asks questions that require you to describe how you have handled work related issues. This provides more information about your behavior, personality and the characteristics. Coming down to next, that is physical examination should be required only after a conditional offer of employment has been made. So here medical tests are conducted to ensure physical fitness of the potential employee. It will decrease the chances of employee absenteeism. Let us see overseas recruitment and selection process. So first step here is receive requirement from the client, overseas client over there. Then search in the data bank for qualified candidates. Also release advertisement in leading newspapers to source potential candidates. So if you could see, many newspapers like Accent, etc. will be having a lot of overseas requirement which will be posted in the newspapers. Then screening of the applications will be done. Then afterwards, interview by experts to shortlist. So Skype interviews and all will be conducted by the experts to shortlist the candidate. Then practical test if it is required based on the job. Then final interview will be done by the employer's authorized representatives. And then complete medical examination of the candidate will be done. And visa is obtained on passport of selected candidates. Then completion of immigration formalities are being done. orientation regarding the company, the job, etc. Or if you could say the training will be given to the candidate and then departure from the airport. This all is done based on the permission of the embassy. So this is the overseas recruitment process. Selection test of Infosys. The basic selection test of Infosys include aptitude test, which judges the analytical thinking, arithmetical reasoning of the candidate, a test of communicative English language, as well as the duration of the test will be along 90 minutes. Selection test taken by HP, wherein HP begins the selection process with a written test, which follows the technical round, managerial round, and lastly it is completed with the HR interview round. So here academic criteria 65% throughout, that is class 10th, 12th and BTech. No backlogs are allowed. Gap of education up to 1 year with valid reason is allowed. So you have aptitude test, verbal communication and general aptitude test, programming skills and question based on C, C++, Java, etc. Computer networking concepts. These all tests are being taken by HP. Coming on to selection procedure of HAL. So here company conducts recruitment process every year to select new candidates. The selection process of the company consists of 3 rounds. These rounds are as follows. One is written examination, technical interview and HR interview. So here they go in for written examination like FT and technical round based on the job or specific technique whatever I will use. Then HR interview will be there finally. Academic criteria prescribed here is 60% marks in 10th, 12th, 60% and or more into BTech, etc. No backlogs are allowed. No gap of education up to 2 years is allowed with the valid reason. Selection test of State Bank of India probationary officer. So there will be many phases in that. So the test like English language, quantitative aptitude, reasoning ability all are taken, each which consists of 35 questions and which composites of 1 hour. So first phase would be preliminary examination, wherein the test will be conducted, objective test for 100 marks will be conducted with 1 hour duration, consisting of 3 sections which are as below. Then second phase will be having main examination, which consists of 200 questions. Descriptive test 50 marks, both objective and descriptive test will be online. So candidates will have to answer descriptive test by typing on the computer. So second would be the first would be the objective test and next would be the descriptive test. So the test includes reasoning and computer aptitude, data analysis and interpretation, general economy, banking awareness, English language. Then you have phase 3, that is group exercise. So here group exercise consists of 20 marks and interview consists of 30 marks. So aggregate marks of the candidates are qualified in both objective and descriptive test, and accordingly certain candidates are being selected and the qualified marks in the group exercises and interviews, and then finally they go for final selection. Coming on to the next part of module 3, that is appointment. What is this appointment? It is nothing but an official confirmation through a written letter by the organization or written contract by the organization through HR department to the selected candidate for a relevant vacancy. So here it is nothing but an official agreement between the employer and the employee. Significance of appointment letter. First is it grants a temporary or permanent employment in the organization. So here it is an official contract between you and the organization, the candidate and the organization, for some temporary employment or a permanent employment. So it is granting the permission for you to be a temporary employee or a permanent or professional employee of the organization. Then understand the employment terms of the contract of the employee. So everything is written, so the employee will be understanding all the terms and conditions and acting accordingly. So it gives certain rules and regulations of the company which you have to abide by. Then it explains the rules and regulations. Then confirm or formally the candidate as the employee of the organization. So officially you become the employee of the organization. Then acts as a base for management employee relationship. It is a base on which the employee as well as the management will be doing in certain actions in the organization which are related to the employment. Process of appointment. So here first when a candidate is being selected and he is being called to join the organization with the offer letter, then you have something called as joining formalities which is being done, then appointment letter will be issued to the candidate, and then induction and orientation will be received by the candidate. This is joining formalities. It differs from organization to organization. So here, when it comes to joining formalities, interview rating sheet is attached to the candidate's resume along with the photocopy of certificates as well as experience certificates, all additional certificates, whatever the candidate is having, everything is being attached. And then joining format with the notion of rules and regulations of the company is being given. Standing order of the company is being given to the candidate to go through the rules and regulations. And then finally an agreement is being signed between the employer and the employee. Then appointment letter photocopy will be attached. So here appointment letter, whatever is there, the candidate will be signing it. The employer will be signing it. The representative of the employer will be signing it. And then finally the photocopy of that will be attached. And accordingly, they will attach all these documents and put in one particular file, which is a single file maintained for that particular employee based on the employment number. In joining formalities, also you are going to attach the total orientation of the company, new policies of the company which should be signed by the respective employee. Then also the background verification data, whatever the HR has obtained, that is to be attached, as well as health checklist of the candidate, which is being attested by the doctor, will be attached to the file. If there is a bond between the employee and the organization, original certificates of the candidates should be taken and filed in the organization, and attested photocopy will be given by the HR to the candidates. Here, total company manual also should be given to the employee to know the company mission and vision. Once the joining formalities are being completed, the appointment letter is being issued, then you go for inducting that particular employee in the organization. What is induction? It is nothing but a process to introduce, welcome and inform an employee about the organization, department and their team members. It is nothing but a formalization process for the new employee to put him at an ease and get acquainted with the people quickly and start performing well in their organization. Now let us move on to objectives of induction. First objective is to smoothen the preliminary stage when everything is likely to be strange and familiar to the starter. Obviously, when you get into a new organization, it will be very much a strange stage to you. You will not be knowing anyone. You will not be knowing the process. So here, with induction, you become acquainted with people, you have become acquainted with the departments, you become familiar with the departments as well as become familiar with the processes. That is one of the objective of the induction. And then to establish quickly a favorable attitude to the company. When you have a good approach by the company, wherein the company will be taking care of you when you are a new employee, a new entrant, they will be making you to meet the departments, telling you a brief about the company, telling you a brief about the rules and regulations, putting you at an ease. Obviously, you will have a favorable attitude towards the organization. That means you build a very positive attitude towards the organization, which makes you more likely to stay in the organization for a longer period of time. Exactly the opposite happens if the induction is not being done properly. Employee will not be able to adjust to the environment of the organization, people of the organization, automatically employees start leaving the organization. Then it creates a negative impact of the organization in the mind of the new entrant, and then it spreads across into the public. The next objective of induction is obtain effective output from the new employee in the shortest possible time. Obviously, when you put an employee at an ease, when you make them acquainted, get acquainted with the people, when you make them familiar with the processes, give everything, what information, whatever is required by them, automatically it becomes very easy for them to perform faster and give better results in a shortest possible time. Then to reduce likelihood of employee leaving quickly. Okay, so these are the objectives of induction. Coming on next to legal aspect of employment contract, what are the various fields which are required in the employment contract? Full name of the employer and the employee, address of the employer, place of work of the employee, title of the job and nature of the work being given to the employee, date of employment started should be there, Then if contract is temporary, the expected duration of the contract is to be mentioned. If contract of employment is for a fixed term, the details of that fixed term is to be provided. Details of rest period and breaks as per required by the law should be provided. The rate of pay and method of calculation of pay can be given or may not be given. It depends on the conditions which the company is having. Then you need to include pay reference period for purpose of National Minimum Wage Act 2000. Then pay intervals, again it depends on the company conditions. Hours of work depends on the company. Then that again the employee has the right to ask the employer for a written statement of his her average hourly rate of pay as provided for in the National Minimum Wage Act 2000. Then details of paid leave, sick leave, pension, if any, it should be provided. Period of notice to be given by employer or the employee also. That is when employer wants to resign, the period of notice, as well as when employer wants to terminate, the period of notice should be mentioned carefully. Then details of any collective agreements that may affect the employee's term of employment should be specified. Coming on to some examples of recruitment and selection here. Facebook created a series of video ads to showcase their company's culture, targeting specific type of candidates from engineering to marketers and from interns to international positions. This is how Facebook advertises its or builds an employer brand for its company. Then you have Accenture, which has recently won the ERE Media Award for one of the most innovative enterprise resource planning. So its program has increased new hires from referrals from 14% to 34%. They concentrate more on employee reference, wherein they create employee awareness of the programs. Okay, jump from just 20% to 99%. So uniqueness of their program lies with the reward of the employee receives. Instead of offering personal financial compensation, Accenture makes a donation to the charity of the employee's choice, such as local elementary school. Their program also seeks to decrease casual referrals, so the employee is asked to fill out an online form to explain the skills of the individuals they are referring. Company has also developed a website where current employees can go to track the progress of the referrals. In addition, employee referral applications are flagged online and fast-tracked through the process. In fact, every referral is acted upon. So as you can see, Accenture has made their ERP, Enterprise Resource Planning, a success through the use of strategic planning in the recruitment process. In same way, Sodexo, Mumbai, Pune, Rajasthan, in 2007, they provide us a They have provided services such as food services and facilities management, started using social media to help spread the word about their company culture. Since then, they have saved $3 lakh on traditional recruitment methods. Sodexo's 50 recruiters shared updates on Twitter about their excellent company culture. Use of this media has driven traffic to the career page on Sodexo website from 52,000 to 1,81,000. You have Zappos being purchased by Amazon in 2009. So here they use YouTube videos to promote the company. Within the video is a link that directs viewers to the company website to apply for a position in the company. You have Microsoft, which holds events annually to allow people to network and learn about new technologies. So Microsoft Professional Developer Conference, PDC, usually which is held in July, hosts thousands of web developers and other professionals looking to update their skills and meet new people. Through this particular conference, they select, identify and select the right talent and recruit in the organization. Then you have a fashion group international, FGI, which hosts event internationally on a weekly basis, which may allow the opportunity to meet qualified candidates. Moving down to the next part here, internal mobility. So it is nothing but movement of employees from one position to another position within a corporation. So it is efficient and cost effective method of talent deployment. So within the organization, you can deploy talent from one position to another position within the organization itself. That is nothing but called as internal mobility. Then you have transfer. It is nothing but change in job, where the new job is substantially very much same and equal to the old one. So here the pay, status and responsibility remains the same, only the place of the job changes. So then comes type of transfers. First one you have production transfer. So whenever there are two branches wherein production is taking place, in one branch you do not have the production running, in another branch there is production and the requirement of manpower is there. So you just transfer the people from one branch to another branch where the production is running. That is the production transfer. In same way, we have replacement transfer, adaptability transfer, shift transfer, postal transfer, precautionary transfer, sectional transfer, departmental transfer, and interplant transfer. You have promotion. It is nothing but assignment of an individual to higher rank and pay grade and responsibility. So rank would be high, pay grade also would increase, as well as responsibility also increases. So it is nothing but vertical movement of the employee from one designation to the next designation. Then you have demotion. It is nothing but assignment of an individual to a lower rank and pay grade and responsibility, exactly opposite of promotion. Basically, it is done to make an employee realize his mistake or for not performing the current task successfully. Then finally, last part of this particular module 3, that is separation. So employee leaving the organization through resignation, retirement, termination, etc. is called as employee separation. Main part of employee separation is you have to make them feel when they are exiting the organization and conduct an exit interview to get the insights of the organization. So exit interview will be conducted by all the companies in a written format. Thank you all for your patience hearing. Any queries, you can call me on my number 960-6699-299. Thank you very much.